Okay, this is Pompano Airport. It is Wednesday, September the 28th, 1994. It's 5:30 p.m. A little helicopter just came down out of the sky right there. And we're waiting for David to show up in his Piper to do some touch and goes and fly solo for his second time. There's the Goodyear blimp hangar way over there. And there's Pompano Tower. The weather is terrible today. It's been raining real hard all day. And then this afternoon it started clearing up a little bit. Now it's just kind of overcast. And you can see it's pretty clear out to the west. A little light sprinkle right now. There's a helicopter still way out there. Look out this way, this guy's not too bad. So we're waiting for David and his instructor to come from Fort Lauderdale Executive Airport. Right now they're out to the west doing some maneuvers. And then they're going to come here and the instructor will get out and let David do some solo play. There goes the helicopter taking off. Telephoto kind of doesn't zoom in too well that far away. There's somebody taking off right there. The helicopter's flying around really fast right now. This tree keeps getting in the way, but I'm standing under the shelter. There he is, he's back. He just seems to take off and fly off and come back really fast. I don't know what he's practicing. We're still waiting for David. That's not David. Still waiting for him. A lot of planes flying around right now, but none of them are David. There he is. Can't even focus on him. That's not David either. That's not David either. Doing touch and goes. Not very much wind blowing right now. You can see the sock way out there. Helicopter's doing, I guess, what they call touch and goes too. Just keeps coming to the same spot, then he hovers there for a little bit and takes off real fast. It's a real cool looking Cub coming in right now, flying low, doing a landing. There he is, right there. Oh, he's already down, man. He got down really fast. That's the plane I want to get. But that's not David either. Plane coming in from way out there. They're coming out of the southwest. So they're landing a little different today. That's not David either. Has lights flashing. Autofocus is not too good at this distance. Look at the Cub. Cool looking plane. Nice pretty yellow plane. I don't know where he's going. That's not David either. That guy came in for a touch and go and he didn't even touch the runway. He got about 10 feet above it and then took off again. I don't know what that's all about. The helicopter's here for about the 10th time. And they're definitely landing out of the southwest here. I'll try to slow so I don't go get dizzy. Everybody's coming right out of that direction. And there's the tower right there. So we'll keep waiting for David. It's now 9:45 and he's not here yet. Erica, wave at your daddy.
Erica, we gotta finish.
No, over here, Sully. I'm filming this for your dad. So you'll be on TV. Wave. What are you doing? Huh? Acting like a goofball. Stephanie, you want to wave at your daddy for the camera? Steph?
Huh?
I'm filming you for your dad. What are y'all doing here?
Nothing.
Waiting on him, huh? You ain't doing nothing, are you?
No.
Daddy's ahead, taking forever. Finally. 25 minutes late.
Wait, Erica.
That's him. Ooh.
That's him.
I heard that skid mark, David. Okay, now he's taking off. This is your first landing, David. You just got here. I missed you coming in over the horizon. I saw you right before you landed. Takeoff was good. He's in a different runway today. The focus doesn't do too good when you get so far out there. I was going to try to show you the difference between 500 feet when you start turning. It's so cloudy that the camera loses you in the horizon. Can't really see too good. Bring it in a little bit, maybe it'd be better. No. I'm losing in the clouds. Tell me when you come back around.
Looking it on.
He won't be. Okay, David, we're filming you from way out there. Let me zoom in. See how good you do on this landing. You're in the pattern, got a lot of traffic here. Got planes behind you and planes in front of you. I'm right at the edge of the runway. Me and Kathy are standing right here to film you. Looking good. Nice, smooth approach. Coming out a little fast, it looks like, from here. No, not too bad. Ooh, man, you can hear your tires scraping. I don't know if you can see us filming you from where you're at, but you'll see it when you watch the tape. Takeoffs are pretty good. You got level wings. It's a very mild wind blowing, so that looks good. We lose you once you get out so far because of the clouds. So we'll film you next time coming in. Okay, Dave, I got you coming in on final. You're making a turn. I'm full zoomed out, so it's a little shaky. You've got five guys still flying in the circle with you. A couple of these guys are really bouncing hard on the runway, and every one of them squeaking their tires. I think that's because the runway may be wet, and that just is the sound it makes. But that's you coming in. Wow, you're really wobbling there, Dave. Oh, that's me. Psych. Got your little lights on your tail flashing. See the traffic behind you. I think this time might be the time you come in to let your instructor out. I don't know. There you go. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. Nope, you're taking off again. Your takeoffs are real good. Your wings are definitely a lot straighter than these other guys. And you get your height pretty fast. A couple of these guys are like not getting up there. I'll try to film one so you can compare it. Oh, I'm losing in the clouds. Yeah, this is like David's plane, but not the right one. Let's see how he lands, Dave.
I'm supposed to get you and
Simon. Okay, not this next plane, but the one after
is
gonna be Dad.
Watch how this guy takes off, Dave, in comparison to you. Watch his height over those trees. He goes way down the runway compared to you. Now he's launching. Well, I don't know. I call it twisty-turny. See, he didn't get the height like you do. But let me back up so you can see. It's an obvious difference. There's the next plane up there in a pattern. And you're coming around. You're right behind him after this guy. Watch this guy land.
I got to use my
time.
Good.
Yes.
Okay.
Time out.
Time out.
That guy, yeah, he's taking off. There he goes.
Daddy, it's a little red light going there. Erica, go that tree.
I don't see him.
Way out, not way out, but he's getting ready to come down.
That guy got up. Look at that. That guy got up. See the comparison to the trees? That guy got up. He kind of flattens out a little bit. Does it every time. I don't know why.
Hey, here he comes. Here he comes, Dan.
Okay. Here you come, Dave. I'll film you from our vantage point without the zoom. Maybe it'll be a little more steadier for you. You can see through the trees. You can see the windsock in there. Girls are running all around. There you come.
Don't wave at him. Don't distract him.
Just be still, girl, so Daddy can fly.
Erica.
Good landing.
Screech, though.
I'm hoping this is the time you're going to come in and drop off Chris. I don't hear you powering up.
I don't see you.
Here he comes.
Yep, he's coming in this time, girls. Erica, I'm trying to film pump him.
Get
off Uncle Danny. Trying to film
something. Like coming in? No, not Daddy, but Chris is.
What in the heck was that all
about?
You're
not supposed to give me stuff. Oh,
jeez.
I was looking at you.
Oh,
Stephanie, you're supposed to give me my mind.
Okay, now you'll be coming in a minute, Dave. Okay, Dave. I'm out here by the runway filming you. Don't go past me, Erica. Get behind me. Get behind me. It's now 10 after 6 on Wednesday, the 28th of September. I'm on full zoom. Shakes too much on full zoom.
All right, I see him.
Wave at him, see if he waves at you. Still sitting there, talking to Chris, I guess. Getting ready to get out. Getting kind of dark already, so I don't know how much time you're going to have to solo. There's Chris. Glad to be on the ground, so he ties his shoes. I guess you scared his shoelaces loose, David, which are flying. I don't know if he can see me or not. It's hard to tell through this viewfinder. There's Chris. Okay, Dave, now you're taking off on your own. Chris over here is going to set up the radio for the girls to listen to. just got a radio here. But you didn't bring it, right, Caddy? Said it's real smooth up there, Caddy.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll film you when we take off. It's gonna get a little nighttime today, too, huh?
Yeah, maybe a little.
It's closing in fast. Yeah, that's true.
Spend the rest of the day.
Mm-hmm. Kathy, when you hear him talk, tell me, because the camera will pick it up, too. Did you get cleared? Yeah. Back it up so it's not so shaky, Dave.
Where is he, Mom?
He's taking off, Erica. Man, David, you almost hit a bird. Next time, try to avoid it, will you? You're wobbling. Oh, no, that's me.
What?
All right. You're up and out of there. I'm losing you in the clouds. Film me when you come around.
Isn't that amazing? It's just the engine. Is
there's a pits coming up, Dave.
The horsepower.
I don't think it was a little yellow plane.
This is that's one of the world champions right there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, this is a real famous little airport for aerobatic.
Well, Red Pit's gonna take off. You should be coming around in a minute. Switch to film you when you come in. Chris says this is a national champion flying this plane right here. I guess he's like kind of famous. I'm too far away from the radio, but I hear you on the, this is you coming in here. Top of the pits. I'm trying to film, Erica. You can't grab me, baby. I tell you, don't do that when I'm filming, okay?
Touch and go?
Yep. There he goes. Touch. And now he's gonna go.
Mom.
A little zoom. I'm gonna go over here, Dave, and see if this pitch is ready to take off. There he is, down there. When I film this guy, I'm gonna film it on low speed so I can see him, because they take off pretty fast, I guess. Erica, what you doing? Where's your dad at?
Let me see.
You're not gonna grab me no more when I'm filming, are you?
Right over there.
Erica, you're not gonna grab me anymore when I'm filming, are you? Because it makes the camera go like this. Okay, let's watch this little red guy, okay? Waiting for this plane to come in. I'll film the pits and then that's all I'm going to film. Okay, pits is starting to move up into position. He's going to take off in front of you, Dave. You just came on the radio and you got clearance from the tower. You're still a ways off there, though. So we'll film this guy taking off. Get out of here so it's not so zoomy. Helicopter's landing to my right now, getting out of the way. Now here goes this guy. Look how fast this guy goes.
Is that the kind of plane that Uncle, that Papa used to fly? No, flying jet.
That's not a jet.
Oh, wait, yeah,
guy is gone. Gone. Okay, and you should be coming in next, Dave.
Danny.
Yeah?
There's a woman in that plane.
I told you you could fly, Kathy. I'm dying to get up there. It's so funny, David. This helicopter right here, Channel 5 helicopter, when you were coming in, they were talking about you on the radio. They're going, this guy's going to come right into us. So it was pretty funny. We were laughing. So Chris come out to see. He says you're doing really good. Tried to see if he'd let me come and take a ride with you back to Fort Lauderdale, but I can't have a ride. So, this is the end of your day. It's now 25 to 7. And I'll film you one last time before you take off. Here's a pretty good shot of you, Dave. Girls are getting ready to leave because they know you're going to take off. So I said, I'll just film you right here and get a close up of you in the plane. Sorry about that, it's wiggling. I don't know how it's going to come out. At least you're going to get a little bit more nighttime flight today. There you go. So this is David's great second solo flight. Dave's solo flying anyway. And the instructor says he's doing real good. And it looks good from here on the ground too, Dave. So this would be a good day to remember. And we're going to go to fade as David flies off into the sunset. See you later.
Tower, 767 Romeo Hotel, 6 miles to the north of the Pompano, Mississippi.
767 Romeo Hotel, he's in a tower. You're a right down on runway 26 for midfield.
Roger, right down, wait for 26 and we have a...
Plugs back in.
Huh?
You ready to put the plug back in?
No, I wanted to crank it with it without, just like it is. Because I wanted you to pull your truck in.
Oh, you want to leave the plugs out?
Yeah.
Leave them out?
Yeah, I wanted to get oil pressure on the gauge.
Okay.
Happy little face. Let's go.
Yeah, there's more than enough room in here to put everything in the way you want it. You want this in there? Okay. Basically, when you're in cruise, you just turn the prop out like this.
Okay, and what's that controlling? What are you looking at?
Watching the tack
cams only?
Yeah. Well, you also watch your manifold pressure gauge will change as your prop changes. See, the normal is that your prop and your manifold pressure match. So right. If you run it at 2350, you put 23.5 over here.
And manifold pressure is controlled by the throttle?
So manifold pressure is controlled by the prop gauge, well, by the combination of the prop control and the throttle together. See how? See there? Now that's what they call a square reading 15 right. and 15. That's a little bit under square. You're not supposed to under square where you're, or what they call over square. That's, you're bugging the engine when you do that. Normally in a cruise, for instance, you set it up at 23 and 23 if you're at an altitude that you can maintain 23 inches of manifold pressure. Obviously, if you're not up too high, you can't do that. Okay.
What? I haven't got out of the truck yet. I haven't seen him to come out to see me. But look over here. That's all I can see of it. I guess I'll get out and go look at it. I'm gonna leave Zachary sleeping because he's still sleeping. Poor little man. He'll be alright. My alternator is going in my truck. You can hear it on the way up. I'm gonna leave the camera running. Maybe he won't know it's running because I'm gonna knock on the door and see if he's here. I'll keep the camera running. See what you can see. I'm gonna knock on the door. Maybe he's here. I'm early, so he might not be here. It's 5 minutes after two. Start here in the front. Got a canopy on it. There's a nose gear. Looks like he just painted the strut with some proof paint. See the paint on the tire? Looks alright. The red is not really that faded out. Actually, it's pretty shiny. It's dirty from the rain being on it, but that's about it. And the white. I don't know if you can see my hand, it's real slick, it's real shiny, the paint is, right there anyway. And nose cone, the prop, the propeller looks brand spanking new, looks brand new, no pits on it, exhaust pipe looks real good, let's see, looks kind of shiny still, it's not even all rusty. Look under there at the other gear. I don't know what you can see. That would be the left side of the plane. And here's this tire. Rubber looks good. They look like new tires to me, Dave. You can zoom in on the hub. I don't know what that can tell you. The grass has been cut underneath pretty good, so he must have moved the front plane recently. This is underneath the wing. Doesn't really show you nothing in the view panel. It's kind of hard. It's getting sprinkly, Dave. But this is the wing. Here's the side of the plane. Let me zoom out for you. This is the side of the plane. The canopy is like a... It says black on it. But it's real faded out, so it looks gray. The canopy cover, rather. From here, I see a little bit of damage or something buckly looking there. See that buckle? That part of the tail? I don't know what that's all about. I'll go over there and touch it. And it's got these little things on the wings. Little lights. You can sight down the wing. You can see the gloss of the paint, Dave. The paint job is like incredibly nice. I mean, when you feel it, it feels waxed. You can see the trim tabs. The FL numbers, not FL numbers, but the numbers are like stick-on decals. Lettering that I do. Looks like they've been stuck on there. So it's probably, it looks like it's been partially painted. Here's a little chip in this. I don't know, it's not that big a deal. Little chip in the paint there. Here's another thing there. Actually, that's smooth, David. It just looks rumply. It's very smooth. It's just a flaw in the paint. Here's the back of the tail. Look at the complete tail. Those in numbers are real faded. Those look like they were hand-painted, and they've been waxed off. That's why they're kind of faded out. I can see wax on the places where he missed taking it off, so it's recently been waxed. You can see the in numbers right here are kind of faded out too. See right there? That white stuff, this is just dirt from the rain. Watch. That's just dirt. That's all that is. But it's shiny underneath. I mean, it is shiny. Here comes the rain. It's got two antennas, one there, one there. Here's the back of the wing. And I don't think you can see a darn thing through this window. Can't see anything. I don't want to get too close to the plane without him showing it to me, because I'm early. He might not even be here. Here's that light there. The plane looks really good, Dave. Looks really good. Here's the landing gear on this side. If you want to see anything. Wind is blowing. He's got like a little cover hanging on this little tube. I don't know what that tube is. Darn, getting rain on the thing. Let me clean the lens. Okay, I'm back. I had to clean the lens off. It's sprinkling pretty hard, Dave. I'm on the tail section of the plane. Okay, left side of the section. And this is the only like little chips I see in the paint. It's kind of like bad little chips. Focus isn't working too good. And I look real close at the front wing. I can tell the plane has been painted while it's together. Like he just shot the wing. See the bolts here? They're shiny where we don't paint. But then the wing, the reason the wings are so glossy and shiny is if you look at the bolts here. See how there's new paint on the bolts? Like they just shot the wing. Or wings. I don't show you much what I'm trying to tell you. But I found a run in the paint. That's how I know it's brand new paint, right? Where did I see the run? Here it is, right here. Look real close. Let's zoom in on it. See right there, Dave? It's just like a little run. It's no big deal, but I mean, the paint is like super shiny slick, so I don't know how long ago these were painted, but it's real nice. And if you look at this little thing here, look real close around the head of the screw. You see where I have a little corrosion around there, you know, but they painted over it. I mean, it's minimal. You see how this bolt is shiny and this one's painted. Paint is real decent. You would not have to paint this plane. You would not have to paint it. I mean, you need to give it a bath. This black stuff right here comes off. Let me see if I can reach it without falling. It's just dirt. Just dirt. If you look inside here, this little vent, see where the stripe is? And that peeled up part, it used to be orange. That's the original color of the plane right there. It's like an orange. And then you can see the red where it just flicked away right there. So they've masked off the red and painted the red. And then this is tape. This is paint. This is orange. This is red. This is tape. I'm not going to touch too much more of it. There's the gas cap. Color is like new. Got one little crack in the cowl right here. Little tiny crack. There. Let me see inside that vent. I guess this is like a light supposed to go here. I don't see the light mechanism. And the cowl's got little cracks right here. Hope this is coming out pretty good for you. Here's the back side of the prop, if you want to see the prop. You can sight right down the edge and look at it. It's in good shape. Here's inside this scoop. You see the screen in there. And you can see along the rubber where they masked off and painted it right here. I mean, this is really shiny. It looks good though, whoever did it. And let's see, these black, this has been touched up with some black anti-skid, I guess. I can tell it's been rebrushed or so, but it looks good. It looks good. It is really shiny there. And let's see, there's a gas cap. I'm going to look at that real carefully for any reason. And I'll just keep running some tape here. I got sprinkles coming down. So try to film as much as I can, except for the interior. I did look in the interior. It's burgundy vinyl on the sides of the seats, and then like a gray cloth diamond print. I don't know if you can see it through here or not. Let me zoom in and see if that's gonna show up. I don't think it's gonna show up because of the wind. But from what I see, interior is like primo nice, real nice dash. Real super nice dash. I just heard a car pull up. I'm gonna go see if it's him. I'll be back. Okay, dude. You're my alternator. Hey, you know what? My van matches your plane. Check on Zachary. He's still sleeping. Funny thing was, the guy's home the whole time. He didn't know I was here. He's watching TV. I am going to get my camera. He gave me permission to go ahead and open the plane up and film it and do whatever. I wanted to show you this guy's house. This thing is huge. He invited me in and I walked through his house. It is absolutely huge. So anyway, this is his new plane right here. I asked him. It is a beauty. You talk about a paint job. It is a beauty. So now that I have permission to look in the plane, here comes the darn rain again. See, I'm going to set the camera down. Let's see if you can see me while I'm undoing the canopy. Yeah, maybe you can see me.
So Dave, it's me on your plane. The glass is like primo nice, Dave. That'd be real nice.
I had to go around and unsnap the other snap because the canopy wouldn't slide open.
Probably made me look like a jerk if the guy's watching me from inside. Now the canopy slides real nicely.
Okay, now I'm going to take the camera. It's starting to sprinkle harder. Take the camera and give you your first look at your inside of the dash. And I'm telling you, David, it is pretty nice looking. Just so you can see the interior, then I'm going to sit in it and show you the dash. It's like a gray diamond print. The seats are perfect. And burgundy. Nice cargo area. Here's your headliner. It's all white. It's got like a little grain dirtiness to it, but it'll clean up real nice. But it's really pretty. I'm going to step in it. Excuse the filming while I get in it. Okay, let's see. Let's zoom up on everything you want to see. Elapsed time, gyro section, amps, oil temp, oil pressure, fuel pressure. Turn these. There's your fuses. Here's your one radio. Seems like he's got some sticky numbers he put on them, because they're probably worn off, so he stuck little tags on the numeric part of it. Okay, there's the radio. Fuses, parking brake, mixture, primer, carburetor heat, control lock, ignition over there with a key, quartz clock, and it is the correct time, compass, calibrated with, it's out of focus, calibrated with radio, I don't know how good that's coming out, airspeed indicator. These are all your instruments you're interested in, I guess, David. Vertical speed, altimeter. Here's the landing. It's just the lights really screwed up, Dave. Anyway, here's the flaps. You need a little pocket right here. Cushion. This has got like an extra cushion that matches. These are real nice cushions he had made up. And your microphone. I guess this is your. Sorry. I guess that's your intercom. There's your trim. Flaps. Spins are prohibited in this plane. Original decals. It's got real nice floor mats on it. There's snaps to remove them. There's a picture of the pedals. They look good. Sorry about that. And here's this floor mat. See, these floor mats are real nice. You see the sheet metal's nice. I don't see any real corrosion. Looks real good. This looks like an air vent, I guess. And there's one here. This says Best Climb 94. I don't know what that means. Anyway, the dash is like primo perfect all the way across. The dash is perfect, David. The glass is like not even a scratch in any of this glass. It's got like a sunscreen on it. I don't know if you can see, it's got like a bolt-on sunscreen. It's got one of these. I don't know what that is. There's the seat. I don't know what these go to. Okay. And there's your fuel tanks, but you didn't even see that. This plane's got a lot of room in it, Dave. And the steering wheel's kind of nice, modern looking. Alright, let's go look at the engine. Stand by. I don't know how to get the engine cover off, but just so you can see an engine, I see like very little corrosion on the firewall down in here. Like a little, see it right there? It's like very minimal. It wipes right off the hand. The hoses and the gauge, the mechanical parts, they're not oily or greasy. They look pretty good. I tried to take the cowling off, I couldn't get it off. I'm gonna ask him if he'll do it, so I don't look stupid. Try to take it off of these contraptions, but I did something wrong. I don't know what I did wrong. Oh, that goes under here. I guess I can't take it off because it's bolted right there too. Sorry. I'm gonna go talk to him now and see what he has to say about it all. Alright. Okay, Zach, do you like this airplane? You want Uncle David to buy it? Tell Uncle David, look at me in the camera and say, David, buy this plane for me. Okay, you just woke up. You're tired. That's okay, sweetheart. Okay, so bye-bye to Uncle David.
Bye-bye.